Does Tesamorelin need to be refrigerated? Well, in this video, I'm going to answer that, but really what I'm going to do is just unpack how to stack peptides with Tesamorelin so you can just be a superhuman. You probably already are, no question about that, but really the short answer is yes, absolutely. And if you're using Tesamorelin, you want to make sure that you're getting it from a really good, reputable pharmacy. Make sure it's licensed 503A, 503B. You got to work with a physician to get a prescription for it, to get the real thing. And yes, once you get it, you do want it to be refrigerated. And in this video, we'll talk about why that's necessary. Okay, so Tesamorelin is phenomenal. So first of all, if you do have a prescription of Tesamorelin and you travel a lot like I do, we have these really cool refrigerant packs where you can put that little bit of ice block in there and you put your peptide syringes, ideally just pull them up, because I can't tell you how many times I've left my peptides in the fridge at a hotel, and I'll be like on the plane, I'll be like, no, and you know, call the hotel, and of course they're like, no, nobody can find it, all out thrown away. I probably left a small fortune in hotel rooms. My wife's always like, what'd you leave this time? I'm like, nothing besides my favorite suit jacket that of course they can't find. So don't leave your Tesamorelin in the fridge. It's so good. It does much better for you if you actually put it into your body. I haven't seen any research that shows that just by leaving Tesamorelin in the fridge that you have any benefits from it. Don't freeze it by any means. And most of these peptides, you're going to see a very short expiration date, especially from a compounding pharmacy. It's just one of the criteria. Doesn't mean that the peptides are denaturing, but the reason why you want to keep it in the fridge is because these peptide structures are very sensitive. And so this is 44 amino acids in Tesamorelin, and they have all got these very specific covalent bonds that help stick that shape together so that they can bind right onto your pituitary and activate your body's growth hormone. So if they start to get denatured or start to get unraveled because they're exposed to sun or they get too hot, that can be a problem, because then you're not getting that full quantity and the pulse of growth hormone the way you'd want it to. So what happens if you leave it on the shelf, or, you know, sometimes you inject it and you go to bed and you forget to put it back in your fridge because you're doing this before bed, and ideally you're following the 3-2-1 method. You're stopping eating 3 hours before you go to bed, you stop drinking fluids 2 hours, and then you're turning off the computer an hour before, and your phone, by the way. And so you may be in that nighttime mode where you're just in this zen state and you forget. Well, from what we've seen in the studies, and the degradation takes about 72 hours at room temperature or hotter. And in most peptides, it's 7 days. So don't worry if it, you know, if you get your peptide supply and the ice block's melted and it feels warm, as long as it's in the container and it's not a box exposed to direct sunlight, it's totally safe. Unless it's been sitting out there for like a week, even more than 3 days, I would, you know, give us a call and we'll send you more. The other thing is, a lot of you have asked, like, well, can I take Tesamorelin as oral because I don't like needles? Regan, I'm scared of needles. Well, join the club. I mean, it's still like, I've done this 12 years. I probably injected myself, if we did the math, it may take too long, but we'll just say, you know, 10,000 sticks, right? So this is on the other side of 10,000 sticks. Once you get through the first couple, it's fine. But orally, there's some really good peptides that do have clinical data behind it, like sarcotropin. This is a liquid version. It's got ipamorelin and pramamorelin. Two growth hormone releasing peptides. It's got L-citrulline, L-arginine. There's hexorelin, that's another robust growth hormone releasing peptide. There's macimorelin, that is used to diagnose growth hormone deficiencies in adults, and it actually is the treatment. So if it works, if your growth hormone or IGF-1 levels are low, you take macimorelin orally, and if it increases it, that's the treatment for you. So, and it works really well. But Tesamorelin just seems to be in a league of its own when it comes to growth hormone peptides. So this one, you do want to take care of it. Thing I love about it is, if you're looking to activate energy, for example, then you can stack Tesamorelin with like Mod-SC. I've got a whole video on that. If you also want to increase energy by using Tesamorelin and you don't want the appetite surge, you can easily use this with like tirzepatide or retatrutide, some of these GLP-1 agonists that are so good for the brain, the heart, the muscle, and the body composition. It turns off that hunger noise, unless you just love thinking about food all day and just dream about it. I live in Midway and there's so many amazing like bakeries everywhere, like Food Nanny, Ballerina Farm. You ladies like set up shop in my hometown. And so of course my wife shows love by bringing me treats. And now I have to exercise enormous amounts of willpower. And so if you're like me, then a little dose of Retitrutide goes a long ways because it just turns off the noise. And then I'll also add in like Ipamorelin with Tesamorelin. It's really good. And most of these peptides, they do need to be refrigerated. The other peptide I've been experimenting with is the Sloop 332. And you may have heard me talk about this before, but only within the last like 6 to 8 months have we had this peptide. And this one has helped improve my deep sleep. It's also helped improve my metabolic flexibility. One of the goals that I have right now, I always set these kind of impossible goals for my health. And so every year I want to just ramp things up a little bit. And so this year I'm working on sprinting because I want to beat the goal of my 40-yard dash time when I was in high school, which is 4:05. I don't know if I can beat it, but I'm working on it and it's been really fun. But the thing I'm also doing is keeping my VO2 max and elite level by using a ski erg or an upright rower. And so when I started using the Sloop 332, I can't really say that it helped me much in sprinting, but what I did notice is my ski erg, I'm almost down to where I can get to that 39-minute mark. That's my goal. And so yesterday I tested myself on the ski erg after doing 60 days on the Sloop. And so yesterday I went all out and I'm like within striking distance, like 41 minutes, 40 minutes and some change. So I'm right there. If I just had just couple faster rows, I would have gotten the 39-minute area. So the other thing, yeah, I like stacking it with this 5-amino-1-MQ. So Tesamorelin, when you activate NAD pathways, you're already working on growth hormone, and so why not bring in some sirtuin activation so that your cells, the cell turnover, you just get better expression in the DNA. And NAD from 5-amino-1-MQ, it's your body's own supply of it, which I always think is preferred because a lot of the NAD that we take from external sources, we don't really know how much that activates in the cell. So like a lot of it just doesn't even make it to the cell membrane. And then finally, BPC-157. And anytime you're using a growth hormone releasing peptide like Tesamorelin, always consider BPC-157 because when you get that nitric oxide increase, you get the VEGF or the vascular endothelial growth factors from the BPC. You can even add in thymus and beta-4 for the full Wolverine stack. Holy cow, you just recover so much faster, you feel better, your brain works better. It's just a phenomenal peptide. So yes, I know that refrigeration is really important. The majority of these peptides do need to be refrigerated. They need to be handled with great care. They need to be utilized as prescribed. You don't want to just be a citizen scientist on this. Run your blood labs. Work with somebody who really knows peptides. Our team at Ageless Future, they're world class. They care. They believe in you. They believe in helping you achieve your bigger, better goals. And we can't help you get there if you're not refrigerating your peptides because they're not going to be as active. But with that said, you don't have to be so cautious with them. Being out for a couple hours is just going to ruin them. That just is not the case. So if you love this video and if you want to go even deeper, I provided a gift because our community is growing so fast and I want to thank you for that. But you can download a free copy of my book, The Peptide Blueprint, and it's free. It's just in the show notes there. And if you love this video, make sure you subscribe. Appreciate you and I'll see you on the next video.